show you something that I haven't seen anybody on YouTube do, at least not with my particular model of Hyundai Accent, 2003 automatic transmission, 1.6 liters. This is a 36049 O-ring, and it goes to the coolant inlet pipe. So basically, that's the engine block, right? Or I guess that's where the cylinder heads are. And the pipe goes from here, all the way to where the water pump normally is, but it's off right now, and it comes out here. So the way that I got that off was I loosened the bolt right there. Please focus. I think night vision is not this camera's strong suits. But anyway, there's a bolt right there, 12 millimeters. I used a little extender and my socket wrench to get down in there. And this is a one that's got an adjustable neck. So that's the bolt. It's a short bolt. And then what I did was, I don't think you have to take off the cover for the manifold thing, which that's a whole nother story that I'm not getting into. I guess I can get into it. It's not that long a story. This thing is like rounded off and like rusted to the frame and stuff. So I don't know how I'm going to get that off. I don't think I really need to. That manifold cover is just, you know, it's just that, a cover. But I wanted to replace that O-ring while I was at it, you know, with getting the water water pump off and everything, and you know, while there's coolant drained from it. But I don't think you have to take the water pump off in order to get to it, unless there's some kind of pressure. I don't think there's any pressure being exerted on that tube. So really, you can do this independently. You can change out the O-ring independently of having to take off the water pump and everything. So back to what I was talking about. I took this scraper thingy. That's not a scraper thingy, that's a hook. This scraper thingy, which I think you could also use a pry bar or a screwdriver. And see that protrusion right there. Please focus. I don't think this would be any easier in daytime. See that little thing that my flashlight's on? That thing right there. That is normally flush with this piece. Oh my goodness, please focus. Please. That, okay. See that black piece, the black vertical piece? That is flush with the rightmost black piece of that. So what I did was I took this scraper thingy and I think just taking off the, you know, exhaust manifold cover, like just made it easier to get down in there. So I stuck it in there and just wiggled it until it came off this way. So that allows me to move this pipe where'd my flashlight go? Oh, there it is. I'm going to have to do this with both hands, so you're not going to get to see it exactly. But basically what I'm going to be doing is maneuvering the pipe and just wiggling it until I can get it out of that spot. I put it back in there so that you guys could see it. Where's my glove? Where's my other glove? Okay. Freaking. Is it able to? Aha! Okay. So you're going to have to fight it in order to get it off. Just twist it so that the this thing catches on a part of the frame, or a part of metal thingy A that's attached to the pipe is going to catch on metal thingy B that's over here. So you're going to have to twist it downwards and upwards and just use the science of wiggling in order to get it to the right, you know. And that will expose the O-ring at last. Alright. So now I'm just going to slide that off with my fingers. Because I doubt that I'm going to have to use a tool to get something as simple as that off. You know what? Maybe I'm going to end up using needle nose pliers. I've got a hook. I got hooks for days. I can also just cut this thing off. Please do not get lost. Talking to the alternators, it's one of the alternator screws. There we have it, a little O-ring. Alright, so according to the shop manual, you're supposed to apply some coolant to the ring. I just wanted to check and make sure that these are roughly the same size, and they pretty much are. The old one looks a little thicker, but I think this will be plenty doable. The shop manual says apply some coolant to the O-ring, you know, when you're putting it on. So I have now smeared it with coolant. But I just have sitting around, you know, the same antifreeze coolant you'll be using for everything. I don't want to have to do this. This is going to be a struggle. Here. Let's move my light so that I can actually see heckin' what I'm doing. Which might not end up happening, even if I... I ran out of nitrile gloves, so now I'm just using leather gloves. Pliz. Give tube. Pliz. You know, know what? I am apt to just yoink this whole tube out so that I can access this more easily. Alright, so, it got a viewer. Rather than struggle with this tube and try to get this on, like, and fight it, I am just going to take that clip off and take the whole pipe out, or maybe see if I can maneuver it to where it's easier to be maneuvered. Get it with these channel locks. The thing is, like, I'm just giving myself one more thing to have to put back together. Maybe it was meant to slide up from under this rather than above it. I don't want to wreck up this tube either, because I imagine something like that would be expensive to replace. What now? Nope, I think I have stuck in it. Stuck-ed. There. It's going to be a pain to get back on. Can I just take this thing off? Or is that, like, super held on? Yeah, that looks like it's held on by the whole stinking engine. Nope. Wait. Yeah, that looks like it's held on by the, thing that's attaching the whole transmission. So I don't want to mess with that thing. I probably ought to just try to struggle and get the O-ring on, like, as it is right now, and not try to make this any more complicated than it needs to be. Where are my needle nose pliers? It's just such an awkward position. As everything is in a subcompact. How am I supposed to get it around there? I'm just gonna expose my poor tender flesh to the cancer-causing coolant here. No, that was way easier than I thought it would be. So what I need to do is is it installed now? Don't think it's in all the way. I remember it was flush. Alright, first things first, let's put this clamp back to where it was before I started trying to maneuver it off. Get off. Bug landed on me. How do I get this clamp back on? Because now I've maneuvered it into a bad position. Made a blunder. needle nose pliers. Raise the engine up anymore, I don't think that would even help. How about my medium size channel locks? I have no room to maneuver. Yeah, this isn't doing anything. I have done an irreversible thing, maybe? See, this is why I need to get, like, some of those, special pliers that they use for hose clamps. Because this is a super tight spot. Scoot this way, please. It's like I can't get it from this angle to push it this way. And I slid it down the pipe, because I was trying to get it off, and I didn't get it off, and I just ended up not needing to do that at all. That doesn't open. What was that? Definitely not going to be able to get it from back here. I don't have the finger strength to, like, just pinch that and move it. What if I use my scraper thing? Nope, it's not working. Just need you to scoot over some. Now, I could undo the hose from up there, but I don't think that would really make any difference. What if I scoot it this way, pinch it here? Nope.
Nope. Nope.
Maybe. I think I'm just scooting it the wrong way. I do both, like dual wield. Nope. If I do this, like pinch it so it's open. Goodness. Ow. This light is too stinking close. It is making my hands hot. Fit two sets of pliers down in there. How else could I do this? Because I don't have any clamp, any I don't have any C clamps, really. Maybe I can just bend this piece out of the way. Oh my goodness. That piece just bends. That's all I had to do. Now I can do whatever I want with this thingy. Yeah, I should just warn viewers, like, don't slide that piece, like that clamp off, unless you are prepared to fight to get it back. I appreciate it, but...
getting so hot. Now the question is, can I actually get any pliers in there at all? Maybe if I do this. Nope. It's all going so smoothly. Moral of the story here is you can get it on with your fingers and you don't need to do anything with the clamp on the tube. It's just that easy. Alright, now I'm gonna bend this thing back down and then I'll show you what I did. A second ago was I'd slid this clip I slid it too far this way, and that was a mistake because it got stuck underneath this piece. But it turns out this thing is soft metal, and I can just move it with my fingers because it's flexible. Let's see. Where is this thing supposed to go?
I forget where I had it. I'll just put it like this. Alright, I am still trying to get that thing flush with this piece. I don't know how to do that, because taking it off was easy. I don't know how to put things back together most of the time, though. I just shove it. Like, will that work? See, I don't want to dull this thing. What do I do? I can use a breaker bar. I'll just shove it back together with this thing. This seems wise. This is a totally safe thing. What if I take these and squeeze it back together? This might work. Oh my goodness, that worked. Okay, so what I did was I took my channel locks and I put them... Okay, there's no way I'm going to be able to show this. Just lower my expensive camera down into the abyss. This is a bad idea. Would you please get out of the way? Get out of the way. Oh my goodness. It's right there. Right there. No, further. There it is. There. Right there. Okay. Just hold that angle. What if I turn on my cameras? I don't think there's a way for me to... Yeah, I don't think there's a way for me to turn on my camera's light. Okay, so what I did was I took my channel locks and I put one side on the little clippy thing and the other on the outside of this, and then I just squeezed it together. I don't know how I would do that, like, if I'd had the water pump there. But I just squeezed it back together. So I still need to take off this and take off the seal, the oil seal on this. I don't want to do that tonight. I really need to go to bed. I got work in the morning. I'm at least going to put the exhaust manifold back on. Took this off in order to get to it. I guess I would maybe like take a flat file and like file down two sides on that bolt. Maybe that's how I can just, there's no amount of force I can put on that thing because it's rounded off. Yeah. It's supposed to be a 12 millimeter bolt, but it's not anymore because it's rounded off now. Where did I put my 11 millimeter crescent wrench? It's like, it's too, it's not, it's just too big for the 11 and not big enough because it's been rounded off. For the 12. Let's take this sharp little flathead bit out of there so it doesn't cut me while I'm trying to do this. Yep, that's just not working. Like, the thing will fit on there and it'll be fine without it. It's just, I don't like it. Like having a bolt on there that's been stripped through. Oh, that's right, I can put anti-seize on everything now, because I got some of that. Like, I don't have to have these bolts torqued down to a specific, you know. I think this is used. Looks like pudding. It's not, but it looks like it. Alright, I gotta go. Then we gotta fight to get this thing in here. Actually, before I do that, I want to put that one bolt back. Came out easy, but I'm just going to put like anti-seize on everything because I can. Paper towels. Put this bolt back. Am I gonna be able to reach this? Arm was not meant to bend in such a way. proper torque is for this thing, but I don't care because it's not supposed to hold any kind of pressure or anything. It's not catching because I'm turning it the wrong way. No. I am turning it the right way. What am I doing? Righty tighty, lefty lefty. Okay. I think it's catching. It's gotta be. To get this thing back on. We are making progress.
Good. You're probably about to hear mine go nuts. They were supposed to fix mine, but they didn't, so I gotta take it back. But how
what?
In your opinion, what do you think that was? It only happens when the car is sitting for a while.
I don't know. What could it be? Maybe. Bad starter? What could be making a crunch like that? Do you mind? I'm trying to work on my foot. I'm not talking to my neighbor, I'm talking to this thing. Yes, I could properly torque these. Will I? No. Don't know what's going on with this one. Like it doesn't want to tighten down all the way. Oh well. Again, it's fine. It's just a cover. What is going on here? Yep. I think this is a good stopping point for tonight, because I think I might have to get a gasket puller, because I could not get the gasket off. Like, I could not get the oil gasket off. And I tore it up, and I'm hoping I didn't, like, damage something else trying to get that thing out. But I used hooks, and I could not get the oil seal out. Which is very disappointing. Wait, I forgot to re-hook this up. Get some water, not to drink, but to dilute the stuff from this thingy so that I can pour it into the other thingy. I kind of ought to wipe down the coolant and stuff. Is that good everywhere? When I took off the water pump, the coolant just went everywhere. I'm going to gently lower down the engine. Actually, I need to clean something else off before I do that. As soon as I took the water pump off, coolant just went freaking everywhere. And this is after I'd been draining the coolant out and had it, you know. Oh yeah, I was gonna take some water, water down the coolant that I drained out, and then pour it into my holding container for it. I guess I'm going to put the motor mount back on because I don't really want to leave it like this overnight. I guess I could. I don't really like the idea that somebody could take this. I'm gonna put the motor mount back on. Well, I don't know. Yeah, I probably should. I'll just put the motor mount back on. Thank you. spooky season stuff. All I'm doing is putting the engine mount back on. What was I doing? I think these take a 15 millimeter. Is it 15 or 13? It's not 13. Why do I have 2 13 millimeter thingies? Is too big. I literally have 3 13 millimeter thingies. 13 is too small, which means it's got to be 14 millimeters, and I don't have a 14 millimeter thingy. Got a 14 millimeter crescent wrench. How did I get these off then? Alright, so I've got a 9/16, and apparently that works. Thank you. it a little bit. Looks like I need to raise it. This thing is in the way. I don't need to keep these on there permanently. That should be good enough. Now I can take my big stinking engine support beam inside. I think I'm gonna stop it here.